Well, Neil Hamilton was a Tory minister who fell from grace. Now he's UKIP's deputy chair and national campaigns director. Neil Hamilton, how does the new UKIP differ from the old UKIP?
Well, it doesn't, because what we've heard this evening is a few individuals who couldn't discipline themselves, knowing how the media are going to report them, and they get in the way of the party's message. I'm afraid they have to go.
Well, so in fact, Lee Slaughter is going to go, because Lee Slaughter was the gentleman who said Islam Obama's real legacy. What does Islam Obama's real legacy actually mean?
I've no idea. First, I've heard of that this evening.
But should he go then?
Well, I don't know.
No, but should he go? But you've just said the people that flout the rules should go.
No, if they get in the way of the party's message by behaving in a way which is undisciplined, then they must expect to be taken off the air. A mainstream political party, not a fringe political grouping. The bookies are making us the favourites to win the European elections. We have a by-election now in Manchester with and Shaw. We are serious contenders.
Lee Slaughter is an MEP candidate. He also said the EU deliberately floods UK with Eastern European immigrants as a tool of choice to break the UK and force integration. He go?
I'm not going to get into defending or attacking individuals for their tweets. It's not exactly Lord Renard, is it?
Who knows? The whole point is, aren't you meant to be, as it were, cleaning up the party?
David Cameron tweeted the other day that he was part of Nigella's team and almost undermined a legal action.
Let's just be quite clear.
Let's be clear.
You're saying Islam Obama is the same as Team Nigella.
I have no idea what Islam Obama is. It's the first I've heard of it.
So let's just go right to the top here. So Nigel Farage, mainstream party, he wants to set the tone. He makes a speech in the city in which he says that women who have children are therefore less valuable.
No, he didn't say that.
Yes, he said that it's understandable they're paid less if they go away and have children and break their careers. Do you believe that?
No, what he was talking about was brokerage firms in the city who take on women because of their client list. If they take 3 or 4 years off to bring up children, they lose a lot of their clients, so they're less valuable when they come back.
That's the message that UKIP wants to send out. They think it's acceptable.
No message. It's just stating a fact.
So they are less. They should be less valuable. You don't think
the client list
women that women
is
actually in the city
what the clients on it are worth. Ah. And if you've got fewer clients, the client list is worth less.
So
that's the simple point he was making.
It's acceptable to give them lower salaries.
Whether acceptable or not, it's a fact of life. That's what he was saying.
Do you think that, your wife's a member of the party, does she agree with that? What about women activists in the party?
I always agree with my wife. Whether she agrees with me is another matter. But Nigel Farage was simply stating a fact that when a city brokerage firm is taking on a woman or a man, their value to the firm is the value of the client list. If the clients that the woman had at the beginning of her pregnancy are much less valuable at the end of the period she's taken off to bring up children, they're going to pay her less. That is a fact of life.
There's now meant to be this rigorous...
He wasn't making any qualitative judgment about it. I read the transcript.
There's meant to be a rigorous weeding out process of problematic candidates.
Yeah.
Multiple sources have told Newsnight that rigorous weeding out process is a couple of interns Googling. For example, Googling people like Andrew McNellis, who is also an MEP candidate. Here's one from him. Hashtag Heathrow. The surly, miserable, multicultural staff of UK immigration are personification of a ruined UK. Sack them all. Is that something that's mainstream party policy?
Well, he was probably frustrated by the queue that he was in. I have no idea. I haven't come across it. You must understand that there's an army of people paid by the mainstream parties, Tories and Liberals in particular, who are frightened to death at the impact that UKIP is having upon them,
are being paid to mine
into Twitter accounts, into Facebook pages, to find any little colourable remark they possibly can to pervert to put in the headlights in order to bring down UKIP.
Let's be quite clear.
They can't hit us on policy, so they're going for the individuals.
There is this backlash in the grassroots who do not want to be talked down to by the leadership.
There is no backlash.
Let's ask a question about Twitter.
We have 33,000 members. What's the size of the backlash?
Are you generally saying that anybody from the party putting anything on Twitter is fine, because you seem to be suggesting it's just a tweet, it matters not a jot. Is that the case?
If it's embarrassing or breaks the party's rules, then they will face disciplinary action. But it's up to individuals to make a complaint in an individual case. I'm not going to talk in general terms, because you can't divorce the individual and the remarks he makes from the factual context in which they're made.
Neil Hampton, thank you very much.